Welcome to the PQRS Introduction webinar. My name is Mac, and I'm going to help you learn more about PQRS. Medicare will be enacting a 2% penalty for physicians who do not report PQRS from this year forward. But don't worry, because it's not too late to get started. My goal today is to help you in understanding the terms, measures, and reporting methods involved with PQRS. PQRS, or the Physician Quality Reporting System, is a statistical reporting program used to keep track of how doctors practice and code. But what does this mean for you? By keeping some general information in mind, you'll have an easier time getting used to this system and receiving the payments you've earned. If this webinar piques your interest, please don't hesitate to follow the link on your screen to sign up for even more information tailored to your needs. Having a general idea of the terms CMS uses is the start of understanding what needs to be done, beginning with the most important part, measures. Measures are collections of information and rules dictating the way a provider should report to CMS, and there are many types of measures, from influenza vaccination to HPV assessments and even colonoscopy follow-ups. With claims and registry reporting methods, you are required to select at least 9 measures across 3 domains or classifications of measures, like effective clinical care, and community or population health. There are roughly 500 measures to choose from, and there are 3 things to keep in mind when choosing measures. General measures that can be used across many specialties, like medication reconciliation. Specialty measures directed toward a select few specialties, like ACE inhibitor prescriptions. And facility-oriented measures that are more pointed toward hospitals. You'll need to go through and see which measures work best for you. Next, you'll want to consider how to report. Claims reporting is probably the most basic method of reporting you could use and simply involves putting PQRS codes on superbills and submitting them with any Medicare or Medicare plan claims. You'll need at least 9 measures to report this way, and I like to recommend this method because it requires just as much effort as any other method, but doesn't cost you anything extra. For your convenience, we've set up a few sample forms for your reference which you can purchase through the link below. These should help give you an idea of what to look for. Registry reporting is similar to claims reporting in that you need 9 measures. With this method, you hire a third-party company who is approved by CMS to take the data you've collected over the year and submit it. These usually have per-provider or per-measure fees. Registry reporting has one other form of choosing measures called measures groups. Measures groups are sets of measures, usually 9, and you only need to choose 20 patients, 9 of whom do not need to be Medicare. Be cautious of this method, though, as measures groups are all or nothing. Every patient has to match every measure in that group. This method of note is CERT reporting. CERT means Certified Electronic Health Records Technology. Now, the C in CERT for certified is very important. In order to be CERT, your EHR or EMR provider must have had their software approved to calculate whichever measures they chose to host. If you aren't sure if your software company is certified, call the support team and ask if they are and if you can have a copy of their certification. There are 2 more terms you'll see a lot of during the PQRS process. The first is calendar year, or CY. This is the period from January 1st through December 31st of the current year. For example, this year's calendar year 2015. You'll collect data during the calendar year, and this is what your future penalties are based on. The next is payment year, or PY. Payment year is calendar year plus 2. For example, 2015 plus 2 is 2017. The name is a bit misleading, but payment year is when you'll incur any penalties assessed at each paid Medicare or Medicare plan claim from not reporting PQRS to Medicare. This may not seem like a big deal to some providers, but your patient base will likely increase as time goes by, and that means you'll see a bigger financial hit. Our goal is to help you along as best we can to prevent this from happening. While PQRS can be tough to understand at first, with a little time and the right help, you can be successful with reporting. All these services are free for our clients. Get in touch with us today to find out all we have to offer. For more information or a specialty-based one-on-one training session, please follow the link on your screen to sign up and get started on keeping your payments where they belong, with you.